From the AG's report, the number 45 or 56% of the municipalities outcomes were classified as unqualified. This represented a solid base for national and provincial government support programs to improve financial management. We're encouraged as well that the ongoing efforts were there to improve the audit outcomes. There were still municipalities that still were able to get to do things right and became exemplar. This was especially encouraging at a time when the AG's audit report represented a period when two-thirds of the council had just been elected into new council. And as you know, almost two-thirds of the councils were new, and about probably just 28% of the councillors were experienced returning councillors. Following the analysis of the nature of allegations reported to the Department of COGTA in 2017-2018, an assessment of forensic reports below were the key common features of the manifestations that were identified. Now, you have just had the MEC going through the latest of the reports, which does suggest that whereas we had concerned in the previous report, that the latest report is the one that's showing overall regression. On literally all the provinces, from what I've seen, no province has not experienced any regression. And the causes have not changed. Amongst them are issues of tenders or procurement irregularities. This becomes a matter of very serious concern to us. To show that having been pointed out or highlighted in the previous audit report still remains a factor in the subsequent reports, meaning we're not learned from those negative reports. Issues of appointment irregularities still persist. Issues of nepotism, issues of theft of cash still persist. Issues of irregular, wasteful, and unauthorized expenditure still persist. The AG's audit outcome is a very useful yardstick to gauge the general performance of municipalities. Municipalities must use this to ensure that they improve in their financial management, and poor financial management is a major contributing factor to dysfunctionality and poor service delivery. I want to reiterate as well the importance of this local government sector and the sector for local government in amongst the three spheres of our government, as well as the center for integration of departmental services. It's important for us to know that when government aimed at fighting poverty, inequality, and unemployment, we see local governments' sphere as being the forefront in that fight. Being the one that is given the responsibility to ensure that we render the basic services to our people and improve their lives for the better, but at the same time also contribute to economic growth through ensuring that we attract the much needed investment into our own areas. It's important for us to always remember that our role is to provide the basic services of water, sanitation, electricity, refuse removal, and also to support other services such as health, education, social development, and other services that make our lives, the lives of our people, better in their own environment. It's also important that we must focus on the fact that we have a responsibility to fight crime, fight fraud and corruption in our areas, as well as ensuring that we maintain the protection of our environment. These are the basic responsibilities that if municipalities were to fulfill These would help to bring back the dignity of our people.